For more on what is driving these attacks, George Burgess is joining me now from Gainesville, Florida. He's director of the Program for Shark Research at the University of Florida. George, so I have to ask you, you know, you always see these statistics about how rare shark attacks are. We had a graphic the other day that said only 7 people killed per year, many other animals more likely. But here you have in North Carolina, 10 attacks in such a short span of time. Is this unprecedented? Have you ever seen anything like this in your experience?
You know, we see clumped attacks where you have several in a row on occasion. But this is certainly a novel situation for North Carolina, which historically has not had the same number of attacks, say, as Florida.
So what are the conditions that are driving this? Is it water temperature? Is it other fish in the area? Why so many sharks now?
Jim, you know, it's a complex situation. It's kind of a perfect storm right now of a series of things going on. We know some things that might be driving it. There's higher water temperatures, higher salinities. There's lots of bait fishes near shore. Sea turtles are nesting. And, of course, there's lots of people in the water. That said, that doesn't absolutely explain why we've had 7 incidents in 3 weeks in North Carolina. So undoubtedly, there are some other factors that are also coming into play. You know, we probably won't discover those for a long time, for months afterwards.
The things you described there, though, higher salt content in the water, water temperature, are those long-term things so that this kind of risk lasts?
Now, you know, of course, we're dealing with Mother Nature, and she's fickle, and things happen for a while, and then they disappear. This, too, shall pass.
So let me ask you, would you tell people to stay out of the water, particularly in this area where we've seen so many attacks?
You know, going into the water or not is a personal decision, and it's a community decision. It's not a biological one. So people have to weigh the risks themselves. You know, that said, perhaps in the areas where the 3 most recent attacks occur, one might consider being extra special careful in there for the next day or two.
And just one more final thought. Knowing these conditions there in the Carolinas, is there any chance that those conditions spread up or down the coast so that the risk goes beyond the Carolinas?
There certainly is. If it's a general environmental characteristic that, say, water temperature is the key, of course, the waters are going to continue warming northwards from North Carolina up as far as southern New England before the summer's out. So it's possible that those conditions could spread a little farther north. But that's not to say that we can expect this to happen.
Right, so hard to predict. George Burgess, thanks very much for joining us.